أنت الأليم الحكيم ربي شهري صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي ربي يسر ولا تؤثر وتممه لنا بالخير يا فتاه يا فتاه يا فتاح. Brothers and elders, mothers and sisters in Islam, as we prepare ourselves tonight for the eighth day of our fast, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept all of our fasting. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us barakah and blessings in the remaining days of the month of Ramadan. Very, very quickly from the eighth juz of the Quran, I want to share with you a very small portion of a single ayah of the Quran. The chapter itself is Surah Al-An'am, which is the sixth surah in the order of recitation. It is the eighth sipara or the eighth juz of the Quran, and the verse is verse number 151. Before I read this ayah of the Quran to you and explain to you this ayah of the Quran, I want you to learn one Arabic word. Small word, not a lot of details, but just a little summary of it. A word in Arabic known as ihsan. What is ihsan in Arabic? Linguistically, the word ihsan, if you translate it and if you find it from numerous ahadith, the word ihsan means excellence. The word ihsan means pinnacle. The word ihsan means the best of the best. That's what ihsan actually means. For example, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he was asked by Jibreel alayhi salam, when he came and he joined his knees with the knees of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the famous hadith, he said, what is Islam? What is Iman? And then he asked, what is Ihsan? The climax of Abdu, meaning that being the slave of Allah. So he said, أَنْتَ عَبُدَ اللَّهَ كَأَنَّكَ تَرَاهُ فَإِن لَّمْ تَكُنْ تَرَاهُ فَإِنَّهُ يَرَكْ. Meaning Ihsan, the excellence of all times. In the Quran, Allah mentions, والتين والزيتون وطور سينين وهذا البلد الأمين لقد خلقنا الإنسان في أحسن. The same word إحسان, أحسن comes. So the word أحسن or إحسان in Arabic means the best of the best. Before I get to this ayah of the Quran, keep that word in your mind. Now let's get to this ayah of the Quran. Chapter number 6, juz number 8, verse number 151. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, and he says, قل تعالوا أتلوا ما حرم ربكم عليكم. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, announce to them that come, let your Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala recite upon you, recite unto you what will Allah recite upon to us? Ma harrama rabbukum, for what Allah has forbidden and made haram upon you. Come and listen to the things that Allah has made haram upon all of you. So the statement shows us that now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will count the things that are haram upon us. And that is very true. But there's one different, and this is what I want you to take back with you. So the Quran says, let me count these things to you. So the Quran says, Allah tushriku bihi shay'a. Number one, do not make shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm going to skip number two for just a few minutes. Just only 1 minute, I'm going to skip number two. Number three, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the second is, wa bil walidaini ihsana. I'm going to skip that. Number three, wa iyyahu. Do not take the life of your children. Do not kill your children because of bankruptcy and lack of wealth and provision. It is Allah who sustains you, and it is Allah who sustains your children as well. Number three, Allah mentions. Number one is, don't make shirk unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two, I skipped. Number three, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, do not take the life of your children because of bankruptcy and lack of wealth. Number four, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا الْفَوَاحِشَ مَا ظَهَرَ مِنْهَا وَمَا بَتَنْ. Don't come close to indecent things. Don't come close to fawahish, lewd, and things which are immoral. Don't even come close to them. Apparent or not, stay away from fawahish, the immoral actions. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the fifth thing, وَلَا تَقْتُلُ النَّفْسَ الَّتِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ. And do not take the life of anyone unjustly. So these are big, big sins, right? Don't make shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do not take the life of your children because of bankruptcy. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also mentions, do not come close to lewd and indecent actions. And do not take the life of anyone without justice. Meaning, these are big sins. But all of a sudden, in the middle of all of this, Allah says, وَبِلْ وَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. And be the best to your parents. But I thought that this ayat of the Quran was going to tell us about haram things. But why is Allah saying, be the best to the parents? Think about it, right? He'll recite to you, مَا حَرَّمَ رَبُّكُمْ. What Allah has made haram for you. He says, don't do shirk, don't take the life of your children, do not take the life of others with injustice, and do not come close to lewd actions. But then all of a sudden Allah says, وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. And be the best to the parents. So the scholars have mentioned a very beautiful point. They have said that anything less than the best with the parents is considered to be a wrong. For every action in our lives, we are never told to be the best for it to be accepted. For example, our fast. Sometimes we look at haram, but our fast is still okay, even though it's not the best. I made my salah, but I was thinking about other things in my salah, but my salah is still valid. So for every action in our lives, in our deeds, we are not asked for excellence for it to be accepted. The only deed in our lives that requires excellence for it to be accepted is our relationship with our parents. Anything less than ihsan is not accepted. If you tell me you're okay with your parents, that's not enough. If you tell me you're good with your parents, that's not good enough. You have to be excellent with your parents. That's what the Quran is saying. Let me read to you those things that Allah has made haram upon you. Killing of individuals, taking the lives and all that. And in the middle Allah says, وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. It is not acceptable for the parents. So for us who have our parents, cherish every moment of their lives. Wallahi, I know kids who tell me, I wish Mufti Farhan my phone would ring once more and it would say dad on it. I wish my phone would ring and I can say, yes dad, what can I do for you? But I know he's no more with me. So for those who have the parents, cherish them. Because anything less than the excellence is not accepted for parents. Do the best for them in your interaction, in your speaking, in your dealing, in anything that you do with them. Do the best for them. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the tawfiq to be the best with our parents. And for those whose parents have passed away, you have the reasons of dua and supplication for them. Do sadaqat on their behalf. Pray on their behalf. And if you have any relatives that are still alive, that are closest to your parents, as your uncles and your aunts and paternal and maternal relatives, keep a close relationship with them. As the Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam recommended us, that after the passing away of your parents, then keep that relationship going on with your relatives, your aunts and your uncles that are blood related to your parents. Keep relationship with them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq. Before I finish, I humbly request you, one of my very good friends, Mufti Aziz,